Alright, and we're recording. Hey gang, Andy here, coming at you, boop, with a lost episode of sorts for the Andy Japandi series. So, as you guys know, like very early on in the Andy Japandi series, I did a tribute to the late great Roger Swan called Real Life Shenmue 5-Year Anniversary, where I show you guys around my local neighborhood of Yokosuka, Japan, and basically try to recreate like a shot-for-shot, as best as I could at the time, of what Roger Swan saw back in the day when he was living out in Japan as Tokyo Swan. So these little collection of clips were clips that I shot when I was on the Yokosuka Naval Base, and for the most part they didn't really match up with the rest of the video, so I didn't include them in the Real Life Shenmue episode. And that was the intention, was to make it like its own separate episode, or just like another Andy Japandi series video where I just show you around the base. But I never really got around to editing it until now, so enjoy the clips, and enjoy Yokosuka Naval Base. See you in the next bit.
Okay, now we're back on base here, and show you around to some of the different places that Roger Swan touched upon when he was here. Now, because a little spider web caught on me, but yeah, sorry about that. But anyway, yeah, he only went to a couple places out here. So I don't know if I'll give like an extended tour sometime in the future. If you guys like, I'll do my best to do so. But for now, for the purposes of this video, we'll just touch on some of the places that he went to. So yeah, stay tuned for the next little bit. Okay, so here's a little extra. As I was walking towards the next and commissary, I just found this little thing. It's called Monument to Hakusen, and I think that's how you pronounce it. But anyway, here's the English a little bit here. Let me zoom out so you can read everything. Okay, so if you guys need a little more time, feel free to pause the video. Otherwise, we move on to the Japanese side. Okay. As always, if you need more time, feel free to pause the video. Alright, so this entire base is lined with these weird little mountain things, and they're pretty cool. And I guess they were once formerly used as military bunkers and whatnot. So you'd see little signs like, Long doesn't have it, but you'd say like, do not enter, cave collapse, or something of the like. But yeah, so you see them all over the base, and I guess they were once military bunkers for World War II and whatnot. So yeah, pretty interesting stuff. Pretty interesting stuff indeed. All right, see you guys in the next bit. All right, so I decided to stop by this little park area here. Before we hit the next, and there's a little park area just to kind of relax. They got a McDonald's out there in the distance. Just wanted to show you guys the view out here of the ocean and the little islands and whatnot around here. And let's see if we can see some sea life. Yeah. Not really a whole lot out today, but some places you can actually see starfish and jellyfish and all that kind of stuff. It's pretty cool. So anyway, yeah, let's keep moving on to the next one. This is called Kosono Park, by the way. So here's a little placard for that, and a small little one for the American Cherry Blossom Festival here. Good stuff. All right. Let's keep on moving. Alright, so we're here in the a food court, and they got like a Popeyes, Manchu Walk, and like a Subway, Baskin Robbins, and A&W Root Beer down the far end. So yeah, I can get a little crazy if you kind of think about it. You know, for some people, they may not get a chance to get some of these things when they're out here in Japan, but you know, if you're stationed out here in Japan rather than just simply coming out here teaching English or whatever, then these are some of the perks to kind of keep you sane if you're just starting to feel a little homesick. You know, get some A&W root beer and whatnot. It actually does taste like the real thing. It's not some weird Japanified version of it. So, and then they got some American sports on the tube. So, yeah, let's keep this show rolling. All right, see you in the next bit. And to continue on, they also have a Sbarro's out here too, which is pretty cool. But I'm trying to cut back on a couple LBs, so I can't be here too much. But yeah, just a little something else to note. So yeah, let's keep this train moving. All right, here's another little park area. Nice little view of the sea. And you can see a Japanese ship out there in the distance. Maybe it's kind of bright out here. I apologize. You can hear a little symphony out there playing off in the distance. You got some little sailboats and whatnot going on. This is just a wonderful view out here. That's definitely one of the highlights of living out here in Japan. It's just, there's so much to see. And here's a nice little baseball field where we usually do PT, you know, physical training, workout, run, and all that kind of stuff. So, it's a little hard on the knees, the feet, and the ankles, and all that for me. But I am getting better, so that's good. And, just continuing on. Sorry about the wind if it's on the video. I'm trying to block it as much as I can, but I can only do so much. Anyway, let's keep walking to another little thing I want to show you guys here. I got a little cat under the table there. But something I want to show you guys, and I think a couple other J vloggers might have covered it. I know Kurt from the Softy Papa channel definitely covered it at some point, or at least he showcased it a couple times. So, yeah. Hello, kitty. How are you? Chillax. Anyway, it's these rock-looking things, and they're not actually rocks. They're if you look at them close enough, they look like little little jacks that you used to play with. You know, you'd drop the ball and grab the jacks. They look a lot like that, actually, but they're meant to be tsunami protection, I guess. And you know, they hold off a lot of the shock waves, huge tidal waves and stuff like that, so that's pretty cool. And yeah, thought I'd give you guys a little looky-loo at that. Oh, there's another cat prowling around in the grass. Yeah. Oh, check this out. There's a seahawk. I don't know if you can see him. He's kind of up there, and it's hard to see in this phone, but hopefully you guys saw him. If not, there's going to be a couple more in the next little place we're going, so you definitely will get your seahawk fix. I guarantee. Guarantee. Yeah, here's a nice little area, and there's a close-up of the jack-looking rocks. They look like jacks next to regular rocks. So I got some seaweed and whatnot just kind of floating to the surface and all that jazz. So yeah, let's keep on moving to oh, look at these flowers. They're nice. Sorry, they look like little buttercups. ADD moment. Anywho's whizzle. Let's keep on moving to this area up here so you can get your seahawk fix. Hopefully they're out. They usually like to come out when there's a lot of food and whatnot. Oh, there's some Japanese freighters, and I think you can see some stuff out there in the distance. I don't know how good this cell phone would capture stuff out there, but hopefully you guys can see it. Anyway, here's the volleyball court. This, yeah, just step up there. That. About tripped. Ooh. Ew, dead fish. Gross. Maybe one of the seahawks captured it, brought it up to shore. Yeah, yep, there's one. You can see. Well, actually, no, wait, that's a crow. I'm sorry, I forgot. Now, I know I've shown some videos with the crows out in San Diego, and they were pretty big, but they're absolutely ginormous out here. Like, they're way bigger than the ones back in San Diego. Some of them even look like hawks. It's crazy. Speaking of which, the hawks aren't really out as much today. But anyway, usually when commands are throwing picnics and stuff like that, usually on Fridays, I got some food out and whatnot. Out here, actually, these little gazebo-like areas. They like to kind of fly around. They look like buzzards, and sometimes if you're not careful, they swoop down and eat your food. And I know that Jason from the My Argonauts channel covered that in a little more detail because his school has a similar problem as well. So him out here at a Masulka Park. See, there's a little placard here too. So you can see Masulka Park. Okay. This park is named for the Honorable Ichiro Masulka, Mr. Navy, a true friend and selfless supporter of the Navy and the United States-Japan security relationship. Because of his perseverance and dedication, our sailors and their families enjoy a significantly improved quality of life. He shall live forever in our hearts. What a nice guy. So, anyway, let's keep this train moving. Hopefully, you'll at least get to see one Seahawk. They like to come in a little close, and it can get pretty scary because they're quite huge. Too bad. And no Seahawks. I'm sorry, guys. Hopefully in a future video I'll be able to show some more Seahawks. But yeah, for this one, not so much. I apologize. Anyway, now that we've pretty well covered some of the key points of the base here, let's move on to the next little bit. See you there. Go Seahawks indeed. Ironically enough, this field is named after the Seahawks. Ironically enough, there's none around. Even with some cooking going on over there, I kind of hoped that we get at least one Seahawk circling around, but I guess they're off doing other things right now. So yeah, once again, see you guys in the next little bit. All right, it's really super freaking hot out. So, got another vending machine here, Coke, and I'm gonna get some water. So this is water. So one bottle, 120 yen. I should get some. And this is a 500 yen coin, by the way. So go up to here, press Z button. And the cool thing is, you should change down there. Yeah, all 100 yen coins, baby. Yeah. Alright. Alright, let's drink up. I really need it. I think I'm gonna be super sunburned today, but did it all for you guys. So yeah, stay tuned for the next little bit. That's pretty cool. They got a skate park out here too. So yeah, did not know that. Oop! Almost had a 1 million view on YouTube. So close. Ah well. Anyways, Wizzle. Let's move on to the next little bit here. And yes, in case you guys are wondering, they do have a Taco Bell right next to a Starbucks. So, yeah, apparently there's not a lot of Taco Bells out here. The only ones that are here in Japan are the ones on American military bases like this one. So, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna go and eat some bad things. So, yeah, see you next little bit. So, yeah, definitely gonna have to run this off at some point, but yeah. And now it's a nice Crunchwrap Supreme combo, soft taco, hot sauce, and a nice tall thing of wild cherry Pepsi. So yeah, gonna scarf this down and we'll see you guys in the next little bit. Later. So here's some more of those former like hill-like bunkers I was telling you about. Yeah. Excuse me. Just had some extra ones up here. They're really cool to look at. I like pass by them every day, so it's pretty cool. Pretty cool. Sorry if you can't see them all that well. It's really bright out. Yeah. Kind of reminds me actually of the old Pokemon games, Mount Silver, actually. Oddly enough, see, yeah, they had the door there and entrance to the old World War II bunkers. Good shit, good shit. And obviously, I think they've been closed out, so probably all worn out in any event, so. Yeah, we'll head off to out on town, and yeah, see you guys in the next little bit. Hey guys, found some subs. I are a good sonar tech, frickadert. Yep, here's some Japanese subs being docked here, so you can tell by the flag. Kind of just parked next to each other. There's a Japanese destroyer out there as well, so that's pretty cool. Yeah, see you guys in the next little bit. Here's a massive dry dock out here too, for all the ships to come in and get repairs and whatnot, and it's kind of giving me vertigo. So I'm sitting here on this catwalk, trying not to freak out. So, yeah, I have a big fear of heights. So, yeah, but I thought I'd get this to you guys. It looks pretty cool. Good stuff, good stuff. All right, see you guys in the next little bit. Let's keep on walking. See, I got the dry dock and whatnot, and yeah, pretty crazy out here, huh? Got a carrier out in the distance. I don't know if that's the George Washington or some other carrier, but yeah. Anywho's a whistle. See you guys in the next little bit. Here we go. Battle stations. Yeah, I'm right outside my ship, the USS Lassen. It's right behind me there. So, yeah, I just thought I'd give you guys a little look at what the ship looks like. It's definitely a lot bigger than the Kurtz was, a little tiny frigate versus a destroyer. So, yeah, I'll let you guys have a look at that in the next little bit. See you there. Hopefully you guys can see it. It's like really friggin' bright outside. There's the Lassen on the left, and then the Fitzgerald on the right. So we're just kind of sharing burthens right now. So yeah, it's kind of hard to tell from the back end, but you know, if you see it from the side, it's definitely a lot bigger and there's a lot more to it. But yeah, this is just my little side of town, little slice of life, the life of the old Andy-san. Got some scooters here for the workers, not us, but other peeps. But yeah, here's another vending machine I like to go to in the morning to get my coffee on, and get a thing of Dr. Pepper, which is out here as well. And one other thing, if you guys think that this is water, this is not. Same with this. These are like, not even like Japanese Gatorade, it's actually just like a soda, essentially. This one has like vitamins and stuff in it, so that's pretty good. This one, it's hard to explain what they taste like. It's kind of like grapefruit. It's like the best I can come up with, but it's good. Just don't think it's water. This is water. This good. This not good for water. So, and they got like different coffees. And another thing is, if you see it in blue right here, that means it's cold. So cold, 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 cold. Tea. Cold, 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 cold. And all these other things, cold, 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 cold. Red, it's hot. So if you want your coffee hot, just look for the red little stickers here, and you'll have the hot version of coffee or real milk tea or whatnot. So yeah, see you guys in the next little bit here. Man alive, this all this walking, especially in this heat, has got me building up a thirst. So I needed some Evian water, one bottle, 120 yen. I should buy some. that's all of it, yeah. Then lift up here and grab water. Whew. Hope you guys enjoy this video. I'm walking on a pretty mean blister on my right foot, so it's definitely put me in a lot of pain, but hey, cheers to you guys and to one Mr. Roger Swan, who this video is dedicated to. So yeah, let's drink up. Raise your bottles, your glasses, your cans to one Mr. Roger Swan. Stay classy. Oh, that's well deserved. Sweating like a pig out of here.
So yeah, this is the Andy Sign. Sign up for now. Thinking you guys, Book, for tuning in to my humble little tour of the Yokosuka Naval Base in Yokosuka, Japan, and for watching my other stuff. Also want to thank you guys for liking, the thumbs, commenting, subscribing, send a few friends to the party. And hey, as always, we'll see you next time. Catch you later, guys. Bye.